Like I said in the overview for backing up WordPress, I use plugins, and I use one in particular, and it's WP Twin. It was written or co-written by a couple of friends of mine, Will Matos, who's an IT genius, and Jason Fladlin, who's a master internet marketer. These guys, when they put out a plugin or some kind of software, you know it's going to work. So I stand behind this fully. I'm going to give you a link here in a minute. It is an affiliate link. If you buy the product through my affiliate link, I will get a commission, just FYI. But I love WP Twin. So let's go take a look at WP Twin real quick. This is the website. I'll tell you the URL, the special URL you can use to get this. But basically they're saying clone a WordPress blog in under 57 seconds. How it works. They give you a full tutorial once you buy the product. Then, so you create your clone, you deploy your clone to restore it. It's a phenomenal product. I love it. I use it every day because I make, you know, websites all the time. So let me just show you how to do this part, create your clone, because I want to do that for this website. So log into your FTP client, go to your WP content folder, and then your plugins folder, and then go find, now you will have had to buy this first, go find your wptwin.php file. I'm sorry, you actually need to go to the root of your domain. Drag that into the root. Now the trick with this is you actually have to be logged into your dashboard in order for this to work. And then what you do is you change your URL to your domain / wptwin.php and you hit enter. And this form basically walks you through the entire thing. Now, if you just have a website there and no like additional folders that you've stored at your FTP site, don't click this box. And it tells you not to click that box unless you really know what you're doing. Then click the button below to clone the site. And it literally takes, you know, a minute or two to clone an entire site. Even a big one might take no more than 5 minutes. So there it is. What you can do now is click on this link, save it. There it is. I have a complete clone of both the files and the database that are necessary to make WordPress run for this website. When you're done to eliminate, you know, storage space, delete the clone, that deletes it off the server, and you're done. Okay, that's pretty simple. Going back here, there's Backup Buddy, which is another plugin for WordPress. It's a premium plugin as well. I don't have an affiliate relationship with them, but I've heard nothing but good things about Backup Buddy, and it looks like this. So here's their website. They can do the backups, the restores, and the migrates, just like WP Twin. It's a little pricier. If you want two sites, it's $75, 10 sites, it's $100, or unlimited sites, it's $150. I think WP Twin is just unlimited for like $97. Yeah, unlimited for $97. But Backup Buddy is great. I would not ever hesitate to recommend that, except it costs a little bit more if you want to protect all of your sites. There is a free alternative, and I haven't used it. Full disclosure, I have not used it. It's called XCloner, and you can get it for free from WordPress.org. I'll be flashing that URL up here in a minute. And you install it just like you install any other plugin, and you use it according to the instructions shown. Basically, you do the same thing as you do in WP Twin. You generate a backup, you store the backup, you save the backup, you move the backup and the restore script to a new location if you want to redeploy the clone, and you run the script. That's about it. So that's your free backup. The last thing I want to mention is you can do a manual backup. It's not that hard. It's just not a one button click kind of thing. So what you have to do is it's probably best to go to your FTP client and copy all of these folders and all of the contents within them, and then go to your cPanel and go to your MyPHP admin, which is the database administrative tool within your cPanel, and do a backup of the database. That is why, way back up here, I told you to record your database information. If you have more than a couple sites, you will not remember your database name or your username or your password. So you will need all of those things in order to back up your database. All right. So that's it. It's very important to back up your database and your files. If you don't, you're going to have a lot of grief trying to restore that thing from backups at your host, which they may not have a backup of your database. They may not have a current backup of your files. It's just going to be a real hassle if you can ever get any of your data back. So that's it for backing up. We'll talk to you in the next video. Okay, the next step we take in using WordPress as far as posts go, we just finished writing a post, so now we're going to go back and edit it. So let me show you how to do that. So from your dashboard, you click on All Posts, and then see how once you hover over the title of the post, a submenu comes up. Click on Edit. And you can change this to bold italics by just clicking on the B and the I, and you've got bold italics. You can change your categories. You can change your tags. You can get rid of one. You can add one. Puppy training. When you're done, click on Update. And then let's go back to All Posts. I can show you something about the Quick Edit. You can change your title here, your slug here, the date, the publish date. You can add a password to the post. You can change your configuration, post tags. You can disallow comments and disallow pings. You can change the status of the post from published to pending to draft, or vice versa. You can also make this post sticky. So if you're publishing this website as a blog, if you click that box right there, that post will stay at the front or at the top of the blog. And then you would click on Update. That's that for editing existing posts. Let's go to tags and categories on the fly. I've already shown you a little bit about this, but let's just go to Add New. And then we're going to say how to install a WordPress plugin. Type some stuff here. All right. If we want to add a new category on the fly, we just do this. Click on Add New Category. And then type in the name of your category and then click on Add New Category. You can also put in any tags you want. Plugin, WordPress. That's enough for now. So you just added those tags on the fly. You can publish this. And this is what it looks like. How to install a WordPress plugin, the date it was published by the author. You can leave a comment. Here's the text or the content. Filed under the category plugin and tagged with plugin in WordPress. That's all there is to it.